Thank you for inviting me to speak here at the ACTech 2021 New York City Symposium. Good morning, everyone. My name is Hiroyoshi Satake. I am the manager of Digital Design Center at the Shimizu Corporation Design Headquarters. My role is to establish and nurture the use of computational design within Shimizu's design division. The title of the presentation is An Organizational Effort Towards Computational Design with the support of Core Studio. Unfortunately, our company has not yet given us permission for overseas business trips due to COVID, so I'm not able to be at the symposium in person. However, I am pleased to be able to join you online today. As you can see from the title of my talk, my presentation is about the path I have taken to create a computation group and instill computational technologies into the design processes in my company. It has not been easy way, however, I've been able to lead a group with a great support from Core Studio, and I've been using ACTech as my mentor. Okay, let me start. We are the design division of a Japanese construction company. Now we have a great sense of crisis. The strength of the Japanese construction industry is a high level of craftsmanship and built trust. Shimizu is the only general contractor that has a wood factory in Japan. Until now, craftsmen often solve design problems. There are no much trouble, even if we didn't use digital data. On the contrary, it is also the obstacle to digital transformation. This situation will not last for a long time. The number of craftsmen is decreasing year by year, and it is a big sense of crisis. Our company has a long history, and we have accumulated advanced technology and methods. However, on the other hand, it is difficult to introduce a new method. Also, we have specialized research institute. However, the technology does not be connected to be used by designers. Although it is unique to Japanese design field, we have the CAD operators. The architects have them make their drawings. The architect drawing time is reduced. However, no matter which software was used, the designer was not affected as long as the drawings could be made. Therefore, the development of BIM and the opportunity to think in 3D have been deprived. In addition, Japanese culture, which tend to be closed inside, make it difficult to see changes in the world. These strengths in the past are hampering the current digital transformation. Creating synergetic effects by connecting digitally by making the most of each individual's strengths is our aim. Robotics on the site, hybrid work, craftsmen and robots. Rhino Glass Bar tools as a connector. In-house technologies for the designers. Drive internal digital education. Participate in ACTech and to touch the world. We believe that creating new growth and value will be new strengths. We want to create better architecture using digital technology, and we also want to create better AEC industry. With the technology we have cultivated, we are committed to becoming Japan's top digital company. Jumps out to the world and absorbs more and more, little by little, our efforts led to this place today. We are looking for more learning and collaboration opportunities. Also, we hope that you can use the technology we have to create good architecture all over the world. There are five topics I'd like to talk about. First, I'd like to explain who we are. Second to fourth, step by step, I will share how we establish computational design team, and a few cases from our efforts. And the last, I'd like to share the future of our company. First, I'd like to explain who we are. Our company, Shimizu, are one of the five major construction companies in Japan, and have a history of more than 200 years since our establishment. We employ over 10,000 people and have offices in many countries. We have our many own facilities, such as Technical Research Institute, woodwork factories, and we are developing technologies such as robots and 3D printer, and frontier developments such as at sea and space. Most of our businesses is in the building construction sector. In our design headquarters, we have over 1,000 people. It has a history of 135 years as a design organization, the oldest in Japan, and 50% of design build projects, computational design team is only 4 years old and have 10 people. Now, let me briefly introduce the history of Digital Design Center. Shimizu introduced BIM in 2008. It started with the introduction of ARCHICAD and was unified into Revit in 2014, along with the structure and construction. In 2017, DDC, Digital Design Center, was launched and Rhino Grasshopper was introduced organization-wide. This was partly due to my encounter with ADL in 2015, which I explained more later. In 2019, we opened an external website which has become widely known to the domestic AEC industry and continues today. To summarize, The first 10 years was a period of company-wide BIM standardization. The 4 years from 2017 was to introduce the computational design. We have just entered the next stage of utilizing this in our works of design. Talking about the relationship between Shimizu and AC Tech and CoStudio, we have been participating since the fifth event in 2017, and since that, we have been learning from AC Tech and CoStudio little by little. I would like to share our effort to penetrate computational design in the company. I adapted many advices from Robert and CoStudio every time I participate AC Tech. From here, I'd like to explain what we have been working on at ADC. This was our situation 5 years ago. Somehow, BIM is recognized in practice. Computational design is not a defined idea for organization. No programmer in the design division. Students do not have digital educated in Japan. Lack of overseas information. Based on those, we decided to proceed with three tasks. First, enlightenment, changing mind. Second, education, teaching computational technologies. And third, establishing computational design ecosystem, which we call it environment improvement in organization. There were advices from Robert, importance of storytelling and in-house marketing, importance of line of grasshopper education, with that last thing proceed strategically, big trajectory and small trajectory. Here are three issues and actions. Enlightenment is to first get to know the overseas level, get the understanding of executives, and draw out a policy of working as an organization. Education was needed for both young designers and managers, as college education cannot be expected. To improve the environment, we launched a specialized department to take charge of tool development and project support and keep touching the world. For this purpose, we got an outside collaborator. It is because there were no specialists in the company to manage the computation group. And we went to abroad, we had a lecture in the company to change mind, and held a regular meeting every month with executives. We started an in-house training and created a self-educated education program. Since Japanese universities doesn't educate computation and technologies, we decided to educate our designers and nurture our company's computational design specialists internally. When DDC was launched, we nominated promising young architects and started making tools that can be used in projects. The advice we got from Robert gave us confidence in implementing these measures. We tried hard not to expect results in short term. We built 3 years to reach what we want to be. Thank you, Robert. I'd like to share details of each three issues. From here, let me introduce the actions of enlightenment. The first external partner we got was ADL, Algorithm Design Lab. CEO Tama Hoshigemura has abundant experience in overseas university education and practical work, and has a track record of collaboration with many organizations in Japan. This partnership has been a powerful driving force for us. ADL taught me to see outside of Japan and taught me about Superstar CoStudio. Immediately after the DDC was established, I participated in ASTEC in 2017 and had the opportunity to have an individual meeting with CoStudio. They taught me how Co was born in DD, how it enlightened executives, and conducted education and development. I was impressed by the words that collaboration is the driving force for growth. Then, we researched the situation of introducing digital in overseas organizations. We also held in-house guest lecture series. In the in-house guest lecture, Robert came to our Tokyo head office. As a result of these continued enlightenment activities, we were able to acquire recognition of computational design as an organization. Taking Rhino and Grasshopper into one platform, which we named Shimizu Digital Design Enhancement Platform. Our goal was to consolidate the study functions of design that have so far been disjointed and incorporating them into a new design process. While this might sound quite natural, it was a significant step for the organization to clearly define what was, until then, an individual level initiative. And this leads to an organization-wide effort, Shimizu One BIM. And next, we started the education process for the training program. We started from scratch, as students in Japan do not receive computational education, unlike in the US. By 2020, we have been educating more than 300 people, and increased by 100 this year. While considering the ideal personal balance between beginners and experts, a team of 8 people in each ASMEP field was initially organized by DDC members. With reference to Robert's advice, we have steadily nurtured with an eye on the future. It took half a year for one team. The breakdown is 2 terms of basic, 3 months, and applied 3 months. We taught students how to use Design Explorer in basics. Each term was 12 times, and the training time was positioned as a business. Students learn how to operate the basics based on the original text. In the application portion, students challenge themselves to use the software in a project that they were in charge of or developed the tool with a theme decided by themselves. Students were asked to half-day training once a week for half a year while working. While making interim presentations, we also pay attention to team building so that we could help each other. For those who are lucky enough to learn, it is their duty as a member of that organization to teach others, not to monopolize knowledge. We repeatedly say that. Since it is not possible to give a course to all 1,000 people, we have created an environment where they can learn by themselves. The self-education program makes it possible to build over 2,000 pages of dedicated texts on a personal iPad. And at the same time, we have created over 100 videos and made them available on the internet at all times. People who have been taught are obliged to teach others around them, but we have created an environment where people who have not been taught can follow along. And creating an environment, our goal was not to focus on the specialized team as in option A, but follow the approach in option B. At the time of establishment of DDC, it was clarified that this will be an initiative for the entire organization. We shared awareness that the most important aspect was for the designer, him or herself, to be able to use it. Creating a better design through collaborative creation means on an equal footing, not as a subcontractor from the specific department. For this reason, it is important that we don't leave it to just one person who can do the computation. The advice from Robert is also used here. Unforgettable advice from Robert, for me personally, was to hire a good person for computational team. The first thing DDC did was create rules for writing Grasshopper. Leaving it in a freshly memorized and entertaining state is dangerous in a sense, and we have carefully laid the foundation for sharing with the organization. We have defined the rules for using colors and description that are unique to Shimizu and made them into Grasshopper templates. And DDC has made the components easy to use so that even beginners can easily experience the effects. For beginners, it is difficult to properly use many tools and servers. By creating the component set little by little, DDC provided the recipe so that beginners can be combined correctly according to their purpose. In that way, we created a step-up staircase and lowered the hurdle for the user's computation, both physically and psychologically. The development component set was shared with the organization as the original tools of Shimizu DDE. DDC members who were originally designers and engineers understand what kind of tools are needed. From the features we need most, develop them agile in small units and share them with our organization. Development was itself part of DDC member education and set goals at that level each time. Here's an example of that tool. Japan has its own diagonal line restrictions and shade restrictions. By changing what was previously done with dedicated software to Grasshopper components, seamless trial and error is now possible, and the examination has been greatly speeded up. The point of calculating the sky factor, which is a measure to relax the diagonal line restriction, is to solve the huge combination of wall surface and height. This is also made into a component with Grasshopper and linked with Design Explorer, enabling brute force verification that was not possible in the past. It was a good example of how the organization realized the power of computation. From here, I will introduce two examples of using DDE. This is our in-house developed office project. It is a bright office with a plate of 100 by 80 meters and a distributed building core that allows light and line of sight to pass through. The building core has an 11-story atrium, and the surrounding area is a space for communication and health. In addition, we planned a skylight at the top of the atrium so that you can feel nature even in the center of the building. About the skylight, step one, from various studies, the shape converged to a structure that divides the roof into four, and hundreds of thousands of patterns were created with the height of turning up and the design as parameters. Step two, we visualized the destination of the solar radiation and searched for a shape in which the reflected light fills the atrium space and the direct light does not enter inside. We made a feedback design while reflecting the result of step 2 in step 1. Step 3. The shape was optimized from 400,000 patterns by Galapagos and the shape that maximizes the brightness of the lower part of atrium. Without direct light was narrowed down. As a result, the floor illuminance at the bottom is 4 times that without the top right and about twice that over a single roof. Step 4. We examined the truss layout that maximized the amount of structural members and the numbers of joints and linked the data to the production drawing. The atrium handrail wall was designed to create a well-balanced contrast with reflected light while adjusting the multi-faceted shape parametrically, seeking an image like a crevasse. Another project. This is a renovation plan for a research facility called AIST. As the face of the main building entrance, we entrusted the development of research to growth of trees and proposed an entrance canopy that imaged this. A grass roof with solar cells was placed on a frame in which the trunk and branches of the steel wrapper support the load as a surface. This creates an atmosphere of sunlight through the branches and leaves. Create a large number of patterns by using the grass support points of the 1.5 meter grid, the position and cross-sectional dimensions of each member, and the curvature as variables. Next, in cooperation with the structural analysis plugin, from the analysis result of about 5,000 cases, we obtained a frame that simultaneously satisfies the minimization of the amount of deformation and the minimization of steel frame weight. At the production stage, line of data is linked to production drawings and processing information and used for quality control. At construction stage, it is used to manage the coordinates of 120 support points to ensure grass modeling accuracy. The error was confirmed by comparing the 3D model and point curve data, reading distortion that occurs at each construction step, and the amount of deformation after removing the support materials are verified by analysis. We have decided on a procedure to minimize the displacement. We also AR to check the process by superimposing the model and the site. We are currently working on developing a new planning tool for halls. The purpose is to automate seating layouts and search for optimal seating arrangements through combined evaluation. This tool makes it possible to analyze various cases on the same evaluation axis. By quantifying the ease of visibility, the distance of the line of sight to the stage, and the sense of unity, an unprecedented design approach is becoming possible. Utilization has increased year over year, and based on the number of projects, this year it exceeds 91 cases in 4 months from April to July. In 2019, when the use of DDE had permeated to a certain level, we released a special website for the general public. Please take a look at the link on the agenda for this symposium. So far, I have introduced our own efforts with the support of ADL, but these alone have their limits. From here, I'll talk about further collaboration with our outside companies. As you all know, Construe is a great tool for cloud-based two-way data integration. With the cooperation of CoStudio, we are able to connect Japanese standard structural analysis software here. This development was published in a news release and featured in Japanese AEC industry newspapers. The beta version is currently under development and will be open to the public next year. We also made a Japanese website in advance. With COVID as an opportunity, we have partially renewed our head office. We are proposing the CIMI's creative field, a large concept that shows the future of the office, which connects people with places where they work digitally and improves performance. We provide a virtual space where employees working at the head office, branch office, satellite office, and homes can work with a sense of unity as if they were in the same office. For example, we have introduced a location information system to live stream the state of the office while protecting individual privacy. This system accumulates personal movement history data every minute. This allows, for example, layout changes that take into account the frequency of use of each zone, and continuous improvement improves work performance. As an organization, it is possible to instantly identify cross contacts as an individual My stay history and face-to-face history will lead to a review of my work style, working style. You can also visualize the amount of communication between departments and members from attribute information. We are looking for a technology that can lead to prediction from the analysis of such human flow data. We are also embarking on urban scale research. The block including the office introduced earlier is a smart city model project of the Ministry of Land Transportation in Japan. The monitoring data of traffic, people flow, logistics, energy, environment collected by cameras and sensors is reflected in real time on 3D models of urban infrastructure, buildings, and so on. We have embarked on a joint project with Autodesk to make this a digital twin platform. Our president introduced this at a domestic event last year. Again, we believe that the use of human flow data will eventually become big data that can be played back to the design. Finally, let's talk about the future. In addition, our company is developing construction robots in-house, and we are the leaders in the field in Japan. We are developing Simit Smart Site as a next generation production system in which humans and robots work together. BIM data is the base building information for Simit Smart Site. We have also begun linking various data in the cloud, including BIM information. And now we have begun construction on a large innovation center near our headquarters. This is a new hub for open innovation and information dissemination, including new technologies such as construction robots and research aimed at production innovation for structures and materials. The center will consist of hands-on training facilities and their museum. As a general contractor that consistently covers design build, we are now trying to further accelerate innovation. So, as I said at the beginning, we welcome collaboration. This year, we have widely declared that we will be the leader among us digital general contractors in Japan. Four members from the Silicon Valley Innovation Center and the New York office are participating today at the venue. Please feel free to speak with any of us. Finally, I would like to say a special thank you to Robert Otani and everyone at Core Studio, to all the staff and participants of AC Tech 2021, and those from past AC Tech Symposia, and to Tamahoshi Gemura and everyone at ADL. We would not have been able to get this far without you, and I'm deeply grateful. Taking from Robert's words, we also want to make collaboration a driving force for growth. I look forward to working with you. Thank you for your attention.